So we talked about manifestation and being guided and like your prayer, how that works to help you get your angels on board with you, which is huge because so many people feel like they're alone and nobody's wanting to help them and things like that. But we have our angels, we have spiritual guidance and things like that.
Well, I want to say something that's very important that I want people to know. It's very important that you stop lying and stop doing evil things, because the more you lie, the angels are going to leave you.
Yeah.
The more you do evil, they're going to leave.
Yeah.
And they're going to be replaced with lying demons and devils and spirits.
Yeah.
It's very important that you speak the truth, that you do good, and you continue to think positive, speak positive, you know, act positive actions. Your actions are positive.
Yeah.
Good energy, good vibrations. And it manifests, the super your energy is, the greater your energy is, the faster you'll manifest whatever you need.
Yeah.
But you also gotta, you know, have good thoughts.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? Good deeds, good acts. You know, when you saw the monkey that says, the three monkeys, speak no evil, see no evil, and hear no evil.
Yeah.
So the more that you are in this great energy of love and goodness, the more quicker you can manifest.
Yeah.
Because God doesn't operate in negativity.
Yeah.
He doesn't operate in cursing.
Yeah.
He doesn't operate in ignorance, confusion, hurt, pain,
and
lashing out, hurting someone. Nothing is going to happen for you.
I think a big thing that I haven't heard is about Trinity's role in the Matrix, and I've been studying a lot about transmutation of sex energy.
Right.
I feel like it's a huge thing where I feel like sometimes love seems to be attacked. We're always having negative thinking as far as love and relationships and how that plays into our overall mission. And I thought it was so powerful towards the end of the movie when, you know, Neo had learned all this stuff from Morpheus and he, you know, believed in himself, but he died. And what brought him back to life was love and someone believing he was the one.
Well, that's just a spiritual message that if we don't have love in our life, we are spiritually dead. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean our bodies are dead.
Yeah.
It's just that we're the walking dead.
That's
until we find somebody that loves us, and then we blossom like a rose. Oh, we open up like, wow, and the sun comes in, and we're the most happiest. Because all of us is seeking love.
Yeah.
It's not really money.
Yeah.
It's not really materialistic things.
Yeah.
You know, it's not gluttony of food or whatever, success or getting that job that we want or getting that house. It has to do with we're all seeking to be loved and to love someone and to be loved.
Yeah.
And we might think it's materialistic.
Yeah.
We might think it's money. We might think it's a whole lot of other things.
Yeah. But the core.
But the core is we're all seeking love and to be loved.
Yeah. And if we go back into our desires, why do you want this house? So you can be in it with this person. Why do you want this money and go on this vacation? So you can go on vacation.
And enjoy the vacation with the one you love.
Exactly.
And why you want to eat with someone is because you want to enjoy great joy.
Yeah.
The food is delicious because you're with somebody that you're feeling love or feeling a good feeling.
Yeah.
So we want to keep our energy positive.
Mm-hmm.
We want to, you know, like if you want love, then you have to give love in order to receive love.
That's true.
It's about getting or giving what we really want.
Yeah.
So if we want friendship, we have to give friendship.
Yeah.
If we want love, we have to give love.
Yeah.
If we want more goodness, we have to give more goodness to everyone.
Yeah.
And you know, and the more you give, the more you receive.
It's true.
Because Jesus taught us that law.
Yeah.
He said, every man give it to himself, it's the boomerang effect.
Yeah.
And the more you give, the more you receive. And every man take it from himself, because if you hold it, it doesn't circulate.
Yeah.
See, money is nothing but paper.
Mm-hmm.
Money operates off of the law of circulation.
Yeah.
The more that paper circulate, the wealthier you're gonna be.
Mm-hmm.
The more you give out there, the more it's gonna come in a currency, current. And it's going to flow right back to you.
So
this is why the corporations and the banks, give out tons of donations, yes. tons of money, because they know the more they give, yes. the wealthier they're going to become. It's but true. They don't want you to know this law.
Yes. Yes.
They've been practicing God's laws for good and evil.
It's true.
To do the worst and wicked things, to do some of the most great things.
Yeah.
They have the facade of being good, but behind closed doors in the dark, they're doing
evil
with yeah. it and making billions of dollars.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you're seeing...
And telling us not to do it. All the mm-hmm. things, they almost all of them are married. They have their Trinity, but they don't want you to have that Trinity. They want you to say, like, I have a thought about, like, loving yourself. Yes, you should love yourself, but I feel like there's been a propaganda to where it's like you love yourself and your everything to the point where you can't go outside of yourself and say, I need you, I need your energy, I want to be in love with you, and this is the true core of why I do everything that I do. That kind of vulnerability, it's too much for most people because everybody wants to feel like they did everything themselves.
A lot of men want to be in charge,
yeah.
you know, and they want you to do what they want
they
you
want to
do.
Nobody.
Yeah. yeah, and a lot of them are macho, you know what yeah. I'm talking about, and controlling women and controlling adults and controlling yeah. kids, you know.
And there's no real love there. And even though that's what
they do, love
doesn't
come with control.
Exactly.
You know, everything is about free will. Love yeah. is about free will.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that you give freedom,
yeah.
that I give you this love, mm-hmm. you don't accept my love, I let you go.
Yeah.
And if I don't receive it back from you, it's fine, because someone is going to come and give me yes. back what I
that
gave out.
Exactly.
Yeah, well, that person wasn't meant to be, because love
yeah.
is always meant to be.
Oh, yes.
But when you give out the energy of love, and that person doesn't accept that love,
exactly.
and they go on about their business, because you got to set them free. Like, I
yeah.
love you, you don't love me back, let me set you free. Not, I'm going to kill you.
Yeah.
If I can't have you, nobody
Everybody
can
else.
Have you.
Yeah.
I'm so miserable, I'm going to kill myself. That is not love.
Yeah.
It's letting go, letting that person go. If that give that person a chance, and they come back.
Yeah.
It's love.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They don't come back, then the real love will come
yeah.
because you can't give out something and not receive back.
Exactly. Yeah.
So people that are getting, and it's called this karma thing that people are talking
yeah.
about. So you want to do what's great. You want to do what's good. So good and greatness will come to you.
Yeah.
And think about every individual. Hi, how mm-hmm. are you doing?
Yeah.
Can I help you?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Do you need something?
Yeah.
Think about that.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Because that's you.
Yeah.
Someone is going to come and give you those same things. It might not be today. It might not be tomorrow. It might be a year from now.
Yeah.
But you're going to hear your sound resounding back to you. You're going to say,
wow,
I yeah. did that.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
I did that.
So, and I feel like that's a big thing that's missing
so
where... We're one. We're all one. Truly, we're all one.
Mm-hmm.
Like 99.5, I was just telling her about DNA. 99.5% of everybody's DNA is exactly the same. And when the way you treat somebody else is the way the universe will bring back to you. Even if it's not from that same person, it may come through another person that you really want to have, you know, a good response with. Like, that's just the law of attraction. What you put out, it comes back to you. So
yes.
that's something that, like, being able to see God in people, because the way you treat that person, if you were to think, what if that was an angel right there on the street that's homeless?
And a lot of times it is an angel.
I believe it. I've seen it.
I've experienced it before, because I always tied with God, and he
yeah.
gave me the number 11.
Yeah.
And I went to you know, to give God's tithing, to mail it off, and it was a
yeah.
man just sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
And he was sitting on the bench. He wasn't asking for nothing. He wasn't doing anything. He was just sitting there.
Yeah.
And God says, no, give my tithing to that man.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, God.
Yeah.
So I walk up to the man and I said, I don't know you or anything like that.
Yeah.
But God told me to give you his tithing. It was already an envelope because I was going to mail it off.
Yeah.
And I handed it to the man. The man started crying profusely. Like, he had been praying to God,
yeah.
and God answered his prayers. But I don't know.
Yeah.
But he's crying, and he's saying, thank you,
yeah.
and tears are coming down his eyes. And I said, don't thank me. I say, thank God, because God is the one that directed me to do this
yes.
for you.
Yeah.
And I say, wow, God, that's real.
It's real.
Yeah, because I didn't know what God and that man had shared.
Yeah.
But I knew they had shared something because the man had not asked me for nothing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, he was just sitting on the bench.
Yeah.
I was going into the post office to mail off the tithing.
Right.
And God says, give my tithing to that man. I say, come here.
Yeah.
And he walked over and I said, God told me to give you his tithing. Mm-hmm. And he started crying. I mean, crying. He didn't even talk to me. He just started crying. And tears was coming out of his eyes, and all he was saying was, thank you, thank you, thank you. And then I said, don't thank me, thank God. And then I just drove off. So I don't know what happened, because God didn't tell me to ask him, you know, what was going on between him and God. But I know God is real, because people will come out of their mouths and say, man, I just prayed to God, or I just asked for this from God, and wow, God just answered my prayer.
Yeah, it's true. My mom taught me about that early on, when she would be struggling with her own business, and my dad was really sick, so she was struggling taking care of everything, and God would say, give this $100 to this person. And she'd be like, oh, I'm struggling. What are you? This is the money I need.
That's when you're supposed to do it the most.
Yeah, and that's what she
told me. Let
me
tell you something. As God is my witness, I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
Because God taught me that. He said, when you don't have nothing, or you in league of not going to be able to meet an obligation, he said, if somebody needs something, he said, that is the time that you do it the most.
Yep.
So when your mom was saying, wait a minute, God, I mean, I need this $100.
Yeah.
Just go and give that $100.
Yeah. And she told me, she said she gave it, I think it was one of her customers as a hairstylist. And or actually she was just walking through Kroger's, a grocery store,
right,
and God told me to give it to this person, and same thing, she started crying and just asked God for this, she's like, oh my gosh.
When I first went to Vegas, I was getting them left and right, and then my boyfriend at the time would tell me, don't do that, because he would see me giving money out the window, like,
to people,
lots of money, and he says, you can't do that, because it's going to leave you broke, because there's too many homeless people.
No.
You know, that was me giving it to them.
He didn't understand the laws of God. The more you give, the more you receive. Because God said this law works like this. It works like a boomerang.
Oh, exactly.
So the more you are giving out, you knew it was coming back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because you would receive blessings out of nowhere, miracles. And the more you gave, the more. And most people don't understand that when you hoard, you say, well, I'm going to save this money for a rainy day. Well, the rainy day comes, because you put the curse on yourself.
That's
you say,
true.
I'm just going to save this money for the rainy day. No. Circulate that money and trust in God that it's coming back.
Yeah. And that's a huge thing, because I feel like a lot of people want the money to come back from where they put it. Like, if they gave their friend $1,000, they want the $1,000 come from their friend.
But you gotta release it.
God will give you $5,000 from this other place. And it's so crazy, because God will give you $5,000 from this other place, and you still be mad at your friend. God gave it to you. You don't have to worry about it.
Yeah, you can forgive that situation and let it go.
Yeah.
Because, you know, whatever is going on there, release it, let it go. The good thing is, if somebody conned you or cheated you, guess what? They can't come back to you again, because they already owe you the $5,000.
Exactly, so you ain't got to worry about that.
You ain't got to worry about
that. And
God
is still already working to get you $10,000.
That's right. You don't have to worry. God has already settled your debt or taken care of the debt.
Yeah.
And all you got to do is release and forgive. Release and forgive. Or put it in God's hands. Because a teller stole $100 from me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was going to tell the regional director and her boss.
Yeah.
And I talked to this lady who was, you know, higher in management.
Yeah.
And then I said I was going to do it. And the next time I saw it, God told me, forgive the situation, let it go.
Yeah.
Put it in my hands, let me take care of it. And I did that. So the next time I saw the woman, I said, you know what? I didn't tell on the woman. I didn't tell on the teller. I just let it go, because God told me to put it in his hand and let it go. Mm-hmm. And guess what? I got the $100 back.
Yeah, that's how
I got the $100 back. I didn't even ask for it back.
Exactly.
I just did what God told me to do to release it and put it in his hands and leave it alone.
Yeah,
that's, you know what? I felt good about it. Well, this is a new thing that God, this was a new thing that God was teaching me, because I didn't, you know, I didn't know about this law.
Yeah.
You know, to put it in his hands. I heard about the law by putting it in his hand, but I didn't truly understand until I experience that. Yes. Mm-hmm. And you know, when God says, put it in my hands and don't worry about it, yeah. I'll take care of it, I felt really good. Yeah. So when I saw that woman that I had told her about the situation,
yeah.
I said, you know, God told me to release it and put it in his hands.
Yeah.
And I said, you know, I feel really good about it.
Yeah.
And I did. Yeah. I didn't care about the 100 anymore.
Yeah. That's very important.
I didn't care.
Yeah.
And it came back, but I didn't care. I didn't expect it.
Yeah.
I just...
Yeah.
Released it, and I felt good that I put it in God's hands.
Yeah, and they say, like, I've read where, as far as manifestation, if you want something to happen, dig your ditches. It talks about that in the Bible, where they had God had them to dig ditches because there had been a drought.
Yes.
And they're like, why are you digging ditches?
There's no sign of no water.
There's no water. But he said, dig those ditches, and yes. it'll be overflowed, and your houses won't get, you know,
yeah,
flooded.
And I remember reading that law, you know, and I, you know what I'm talking about, because we can hear the law, we can read the law, we can maybe even understand
it,
you can understand it, but until you experience it,
you
won't know how the law really works until you experience
it.
Because you don't have a true understanding of anything until you go through the experience.
That's true.
You know, like,
different people
experience different things at different times.
Yeah.
So if you never been in love, there are people who have never been in love.
Yeah.
And if you never had heartbreak, there's people that never had heartbreak.
Yeah.
And there are people who never suffered.
Yeah.
You know, because people can't just assume, well, you're here and everybody goes through this. No, everybody doesn't go through that. Everybody has different experiences.
Mm-hmm.
Even though maybe a majority of people have experienced the same things.
Yeah.
But it's 7 billion people on Earth. 7 billion people. So there are somebody who has never seen the Ellen Show. Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Yeah.
This happened years ago. Maybe 30 years ago,
yeah.
Johnny Carson's show was the big show, and everybody assumed, because it was globally, that everybody, you know, had heard about it or seen it. It wasn't globally on TV, but it was national, but it was globally, people, you know, knew around the world. Mm-hmm. It was a lady who came on and said she had never seen the Johnny Carson, and people was like blown away. They were like, she got to be lying. She's got to be lying.
What rock is she living in?
Oh, yeah. What rock is she living in? How can she not know? So that's why I said there are some people.
Channels.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How did she not see the show?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Well, it was everywhere because Johnny Carson was huge.
It was huge.
Like, Ellen is huge. So you say, if I go on national TV right now and say there are some people who have never seen Ellen's show, people be like, oh, I don't believe that, because they don't understand that. There are people, 7 billion people, and there are people don't got no television. They ain't never heard of celebrities that are here that we know.
Right.
That's true.
You know?
So I want to wrap this up because we're at the 20
minute
mark.
We're 20 minutes. Yeah.
Yeah. So I want to wrap this up because we started talking about love, and I feel like that's where it should be, because like you said, without love, you know, you're almost not alive. So as far as the people out there, how can they start to make love a priority? Especially when it comes to the person that they want to be with and just people in the world.
I think people should just give love. Give what you expect to come back to you. Do what you expect that someone will one day, even if it's that person that you're giving it to, because it may be them. But give and do what you expect to receive yourself.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like whatever you do to another, you're doing it to yourself. So let someone be the mirror of self.
Yeah.
So that way, you know, you keep yourself in check.
Yeah.
You know, think about, well, hey, let me think about this.
Yeah.
This person right here, let me treat this person right. Let me do what's right.
Yeah.
Always do the right thing.
Yeah.
And give God thanks, give God praises, and remember, don't let anyone lie to you.
Yeah.
Because there is a God.
Yeah. Awesome. Thank you. I need a hug.
This has been great.
There is a God.
Yes.
There is a God.
There is.
Yeah, there is a God.
Yeah.
And I'm grateful and thankful there is, because if we didn't have God, we'd be in trouble.
Yeah. And no way to get out of it.
The whole world would be in trouble.
True chaos.
True chaos.
Yeah.
Yes.
Cool. This is good.
So I think that's a wonderful ending.
Yes. Cool.